Welcome students to our trade project class. Today we are going to talk about how to properly write a project. We'll start with the first preliminaries. Now, it's very important to present your project in a logical way, in a way that matters. So in today's class, we'll talk about the different pages that are usually numbered in the Roman way. Okay, so the first page that we usually have is the cover page. Now the cover page usually entails the title, where you name the title of the project. It is very important for the project, the title should not exceed, it should be less than 20 words, okay? The project title must be less than 20 words. Having a project that is more than 20 words becomes too wordy. It has too many words and people may not understand actually the point you're trying to put across. Therefore, at least 20 words. Then get rid of words like there, are, those article letters. You don't want to start saying these are projects talking about. No, you just write exactly what it says. Then don't use unnecessary abbreviations. For example, you're investigating maybe a company like the Kenya Commercial Bank. Don't say KCB Bank Group. Don't use these abbreviations. Then you're still on the cover page. On the cover page, you also include your name. Now your name must appear the way it appears on your index or on your ID. The way you write your index number should be the same way that you write your name. Don't use any other names that don't actually go with your registration. Then and still on the title page, you usually have your registration number or your index number. Now for those that don't already have their index numbers, you can use your registration number as this. For example, you can say our school is usually 4300080, let's say index 201, for example. Then our school, of course, you can come and say these are, you have to write the full name of the school. It's not Kenya Institute of Professional Studies, but it is KIPPS Technical College. You have to talk about the name of the school. Now, of course, in this case, in our case, you have different departments, but just first put the name of the school. Under that, under the school, you have to give a caption of the course, okay? Now, what do you usually mean by that caption? Usually what I'm trying to say that you say that this is a trade project written to the, you can talk about the Kenya National Examination Council in partial fulfillment, okay, for the award of a diploma, a certificate in hospitality, in banking and finance, in food and nutrition, and so on. That is, you have to caption it and say that it is submitted to NEC for the partial fulfillment for the award of a diploma or a certificate. Then finally, you have to talk about the exam series. In this case, our exam series will be, say the exam is being done in November 2020. You have to write under there, you say November 2020. That's when the project will be submitted. So you say the caption, we have to talk about the partial fulfillment. Partial fulfillment for the requirements. Partial fulfillment for the requirement. For the impartial fulfillment of the requirements for the award of a certificate or a diploma. So that's the first page or the title page. Now this page must not have any, what would you call them? Like spelling errors, okay? Because this is the page that shows whoever is marking your project that this is what the project entails. Anyway, let's go to the second page, which is usually the declaration page. Now, under the declaration page, you are declaring the work as yours, where you talk about, you say that this work is originally mine. You talk about the intellectual honesty, saying that it has not been presented in any other institution. Then it has complied with the required sets of of governance, the required sets of that is, you've complied with whatever is required for your course. For example, I wouldn't expect a banking finance student to come and present a project that is more related to food and nutrition, because that means they have not complied with the requirements of the course structure or the course that they're actually doing. Then after you've declared the originality and the anti-plagiarism, the next thing you add is your signature and your name. So how does it usually look like when you're adding your signature? What you do is you write your name, so you can say this project has been presented by Saif Ben Ahmed, then the signature for Saif Ben, and then the date. That's what we mean. Still on the declaration page, you have to think about the supervisor's declaration. That is, the supervisor must have a note where they're saying, this project was presented to me, Mr. Benson G, as the college supervisor, and where they say they have approved it for marking. You don't want to have a project that a supervisor has not approved. Meaning, since nowadays we usually have to send our projects to NEC, they look at it and say, this project maybe was not approved by the college supervisor. And therefore, after that, the supervisor may come here and declare and say, maybe it was Miss Anne. Then they'll come and put a signature. And also the date. Okay, so that's all under the declaration page. After the declaration, you go to the dedication page. Now this is the part where you dedicate your work to someone else. You can dedicate it to, say, I can be sent to dedicate my work to my friends. You can decide to dedicate it to your family, to your siblings, and so on. So this, anyone that you'd like to dedicate it to, you do it. Then you go to the third page or the fourth page, which is usually the acknowledgement. Now you need to acknowledge the people that help you in the writing of that project. You want to give credit maybe to the company. If, for example, our project was about KCB Bank, okay? You need to acknowledge them. You also need to acknowledge your supervisor, because they are the ones that helped you write that, all that. And this must not exceed one page. One thing you should note is that on these preliminaries, they should never exceed one page, any of the contents. Of course, now when you get to the table of contents, it's usually a different thing. So let's talk about the fifth thing, which is the table of contents. Now, the table of contents, whatever you put here must match the headings. If, for example, you have decided chapter 1 is written in caps, okay? They must match whatever has been written. If chapter 1 you wrote with number 1 or with the word 1, on the table of contents must be done the same way. That is, if you had written 1, also inside the project should be 1. If you had written 1, inside the project should also be 1. Now, the table of contents must not be typed. And this is now where your ICT knowledge comes in. Where you have to, of course, I'm so sure in your ICT when you're doing your module 1s, you learned how to make a tables of content page. Therefore, make sure you are able to make a content such that when I receive a soft copy of this and I see that this has been written, maybe chapter 1 started on page 1. Okay? If I come and control and click that, it takes me directly to where that page is. Then, abbreviations and acronyms. Now this is the part where you have to include the abbreviations that you've used in the project. I don't want to find a situation where you've said, you have not, in your abbreviations here, you have not given what KCB means, but inside the project you've really used that. Or maybe you've decided to use something like WHO, and inside the project you've not told me what this actually means. So the abbreviations and acronyms page is usually one page. And of course, when you write WHO, you come and say this is the world Health, World Health Organization. Organization, and so on. These first letters must be in capital. Organization. Of whatever the abbreviations mean. And finally, we have the abstract page. This is the page that most people usually miss, these two pages, because most people, after putting the table of contents, they jump directly to chapter one, which is not required. You're supposed to, after you've written the abbreviations, after you've written the table of contents, that may sometimes be more than one page, you have to add abbreviations and abstract page. What do we mean by this? Every project must have abbreviations and acronyms. Acronyms are words that are usually shortened. For example, you want to say the United Nations Environment, you just say UNESCO in that case. That's what you mean by an acronym. Finally, we have the abstract page that is usually a summary of the entire project. This is the point you wanted to summarize whatever, what is this project about? That is, in most cases, an examiner usually just reads the abstract to know how well you've put your ideas, because the abstract talks about the entirety of the project. If someone has written a very excellent abstract, it means their project is also very superb. It means whatever they have presented in their project can be, you don't have to go through all of it. I think with that you can conclude our class, so that next time we'll come and now talk about how do we present the chapters, how do we present the other types of chapters, how do you present chapter 1, 2, 3, all the way to 5, and how do you bind your project? Do you bind your project in a way that, is it spirally bind, is it bound as a book, as you can see? Do you bind it this way? For our level, usually bind it spirally, as compared to the way these books are bounded is for now for the other level, so you have for the master's students and the PhD students. But for our level, all projects must be spirally bound. Thank you and have a great time, and let's meet next time. Okay.